What is going on, guys? We are back with ABR vs. Sorry for Smoke on Snake Draft. My man Sorry is 0-2 at the moment. I hope he can pick up a W. So I'm pretty sure I know Sorry's team. This is Z-Dragonium Garchomp, Rox Clefable, SD Mega Hera Cross, Defensive Celesteela, Standard Heavy Slam, Leech Sheet, Flamethrower Protect, Spadef, Gastrodon. I don't know the entire moveset. And the Lady's most likely Scarf. So on ABR side, Solvest Magearna, I assume. Defensive Clef, either Scarf Lady or Scarf Nihiligo. If this Lady is defog, then the Zapdos is going to be 3 attacks and non-defog. But it could also be defog Zapdos, we don't know that yet. This could potentially be Z-Move Lando or Earthblade Lando, we don't know it yet. So Sorry is definitely going to scout for that and go into Celesteela. You don't want to stay in turn 1 and get blown away by Earthblade, Earthquake, or by like a Sky Strike or something like that. So ABR makes a smart play, goes for U-turn turn 1, gets the momentum early on. And he can go into Zapdos here, but he decides to go into Clefable. And he's not going to stay in here. He's probably just baiting a Heavy Slam. This makes me think that ABR is trying to win later with Clefable. We don't know yet if his moveset is on Clefable. If it's Calm Mind, it's looking like a threat for Sorry's team for sure. So he already stalled out 2 Heavy Slams, so he has 14 Heavy Slams left. But that kind of makes me think that he is Calm Mind on Clef, to be honest, because like he only has to stall out the Heavy Slams, and then like not much on Sorry's team threatens a Calm Mind Clef, unless that's the opposing Calm Mind Clef, then it's a Calm Mind War. So he does just switch out into, yeah, of course, Sorry names this month after his friends. I don't like, he does go into Clef. I'm not the biggest fan of the Rocks play there. I would have probably gone for Softball to keep it safe and healthy, my Clef. Now he has a Gastrodon in the back, so I can see Sorry just predicting ABR to break the Gastrodon and just go for Softball here, even though it's a bit risky. But he's most likely going to run the card. Maybe if 41 is max, then he can definitely stay in here. But knowing Showdown, he's at 41 because it rounds down. So it's still a bit risky staying in, to be honest. So I assume ABR switches into Lady, predicting the Gastrodon. Potentially threatening the Gastrodon with a Trick Lady or with a Z-Move Lady. He does just softboard up. So that worked out fine for him, man. Sorry. As he does just switch into Lady, knowing that ABR would not go for a Dragon Move. And ABR also switches into Clef on the opposing Clef. And now ABR switches back into his Lady, and Sorry goes for Trick. So we do see, we get information here. This is a Z-Move Lady since the Trick failed. He's obviously not Mega Latios. Mega Latios is no Pokemon. So we do get useful information that is most likely a Scarf Nihiligo. We know that ABR, I think, has used Specs Nihiligo before, but now that we know this isn't Scarf, this has to be Scarf Nihiligo. He needs some speed control, and he's way too weak to Volcarona otherwise as well. So yeah, what Sorry can do here is go for Leech Sheet. Or he doubles out on the Clef, and so as soon as he's just gonna get his rocks back up, right? So yeah, so he played that fine, because if he went for Leech Sheet, he would have lost 2 Leech Sheet PP. So now they both get rocks up with their Clefs. And I feel like Sorry doesn't, the Zapdos is just so obvious. Sorry doesn't want to waste any Heavy Slams. He can double again here. He does double and again into Clef, really nice play. And what does he have on this Clef? He has Toxic. Wow, I did not know that. Like, I knew some sets, but I didn't know he has Toxic. This is Fire for him, Sorry. Even though it's most likely not Defog Zapdos, he didn't go for Defog with the Zap, and he exchanged rocks. This Toxic is amazing. Zapdos is gonna get worn down. This means Celesteela just got freed up a bit. Zapdos can't keep coming in on Celesteela as they exchange Moonblast. They both get special attack drops. We don't know ABR's last move. We know Sorry is a Softball, Moonblast, Rocks, and Toxic. And ABR might reveal his last move. He just plays it safe and Softball's there. I don't know why he went into Gastrodon. Maybe he anticipated and switch into Magearna, because Gastrodon beats Magearna easily. But this didn't work out for Sorry, because like we don't know the last move on the Clef yet. If it's knockoff, it's annoying because he would lose the lefties, and if it's Calm Mind, it would be even worse. As my man Sorry is reading the chat here and talking about that, you guys can read the chat for yourself. I'm gonna try to focus on the game. But yeah, Sorry definitely cannot stay in here. I think he's forced to go into his Celesteela. If this has knockoff, yes, it would be really annoying for Sorry losing the lefties on the Celesteela, but this being potentially Calm Mind is super threatening for Sorry, so staying in is not an option. Like, I'm not 100% sure, but I assume this is Toxic Recover, Scald, Earthquake, Gastrodon. I don't think it's Curse. So he does reveal Calm Mind, kind of forces Sorry to go for Heavy Slam, goes on a Zapdos, so that would stall out two Heavy Slam PP, but Sorry is like, nah, not like this, I'm gonna double out, what a god. Okay, so Sorry is playing really well at the beginning, at the moment, because the Zapdos had to take Rocks and had to take Toxic, and he got the momentum, doubling into Gastrodon, getting a free Scald, and he can fish for a burn, he gets the burn on Lari. This is amazing for my man Sorry. We notice Lari is a Z move, so if this was Z Gigavolt, this was a risky play by Sorry going into this, but he wields Psychic, so it's most likely Draco, maybe Defog Recover on the Lari? It's most likely not Gigavolt Havoc. Since he has a Celesteela, it's most likely not Gigavolt Havoc. But he does go into his Lari. I think that was a really good play on Sorry's part. It covers the Zapdos. Zapdos took another round of Rocks. This is amazing. Well, earlier I said he took Toxic, but I think Toxic gets cancelled out by Leftovers. But taking Rocks is still amazing for Sorry. Like, the Zapdos has to take Rocks. So that covered the Gigavolt Havoc and the potential Gigavolt Havoc from the Lari or something like that. And it also covered the Zapdos. So I like how Sorry's playing at the moment. But now he just goes for Psyshock and he's forced out back into his Celesteela. Since he knows now this is a big threat. Wait, why did he go to this? I don't understand why he keeps going into this. And now he goes into Celesteela finally. So there's the Calm Mind. So he's gonna have to go for Heavy Slam here. The Zapdos is super low now because of the how Sorry like made the Zap get up Rocks. Zapdos took Rocks. Zapdos is super low, so it was fine going for Heavy Slam there. He does ABR is spamming Soft Ball here. I think what ABR is trying to do, he's making Sorry think that he's staying in with his Clef. He's spamming Soft Ball for a while, and now he switches out. That was really well done by ABR. We don't know the Lando item yet. It is Rocky Helmet, so that made a lot of sense. Making him spam Heavy Slam to then get a crucial Rocky Helmet chip on the Celesteela. Also getting up a really nice Intimidate. And so he does go for Heavy Slam. I feel like he should have gone for Leech Seed there. I know why he went for Heavy Slam. He predicted ABR to go into Clef. But ABR, oh god, ABR played this really well. And now Clef walls this because it's a minus one Celesteela, so he can just go for Softball. And I feel like Sorry played that a bit too fast. He should have thought more through his plays. I hope he doesn't go for Tricky. He does go for Trick. I'm not the biggest fan of that play. He went for it way too early. Now he cannot trick the Clefable anymore. The Clefable is a big problem. Like, it's ABR's main win con. It can easily solo Sorry's entire team if he doesn't play, like, if he's not careful. And now his Celesteela had to take Rocks and another Moonblast. I completely agree with Moonblasting there to chip this. He Moonblasts again. I hope he just Heavy Slam this time few, okay? So switch from ABR side is really obvious here. Please go for Leech Seed. Please go for Leech Seed. This is so obvious that he's gonna switch. If you Heavy Slam here and you take Rocky Helmet, you're gonna be in such a bad position. Oh my god. So he does take another round of Heavy Slam, of Rocky Helmet. And now his Celesteela is almost dead. Kind of interested in the last move. We know it's U-turn, Earthquake, most likely HP Ice. And I don't know the last move on the Lando. Since it's not lefties, it's not Protect. So ABR plays him. Oh my god, he plays him there. I think Clef could have lived the Heavy Slam anyway because of the Intimidate. Like, I love how he's abusing the Rocky Helmet plus Intimidate. So Clef can eat up Heavy Slam. And Celesteela takes chip damage every time from the helmet. Also, this Lari cannot cripple the Clef anymore. It got tricked. It's tricked at Scarf away and has an Assault Vest now. If you have an Assault Vest, you can only use attacking moves. And yeah, this is a losing game for Sorry unless he gets a crit. So he's forced out here. Obviously, it has Magic Guard, so Leech Seed doesn't affect the Clef. ABR doesn't want to risk a crit there, switches back into Landorus, and he keeps clicking Heavy Slam, so now the Celesteela is super low. I feel like he should have switched out, sacked like the Heracross to weaken the Clefable, but staying in and didn't really gain Sorry anything because he was intimidated, and the Rocky Helmet was obviously even more annoying. So now he has to SD up because this obviously lives a Moonblast, and then he can fire off a Rock Blast, but ABR has a weakened Zapdos in the back that he can just fodder off here. He has no reason to stay in with Clefable when Clefable literally is his main win con. So he's just gonna go for the Psychic Stab here. That's yeah, I think that's a cool play on Sorry's part going to Lari. Sorry is a Scarf, so he can just revenge this with a Scarf Psyshock. And now ABR gets a free session to Clef and he can Calm Mind up again. Or he can Moonblast and weaken the Celesteela. I think Sorry predicted him potentially to Moonblast there, and he wanted to weaken this a bit and bring them range to weaken it even more than with Garchomp, or like try to kill it with Garchomp. But now is this a 50-50? Because like Moonblast kills from here, and Heavy Slam obviously doesn't kill. So if he goes for Moonblast here, Sorry is in a bad spot. And if Sorry goes for Protect, and ABI predicts and goes for Calm Mind, then Sorry is also in a bad spot. So this is a tough one. This is so tough because ABR knows that the Protect is kind of obvious, and he, oh my god, ABR predicts that. Now it's looking super bad for Sorry, because the Clef is faster, the Clef kills his Moonblast, he tries to get a double Protect, he doesn't get it. It's most likely doesn't have much Spadav at all, otherwise it could have lived that. So now he's gonna try to weaken this with a Rock Blast and then bring, and then weaken it even more with the Garchomp. I know the Garchomp is SD Dragonium, so if it was a ground Z move, then he could threaten this Clef a bit more. But it's only Earthquake. So Rock Blast is gonna do around maybe 45%. Sorry has to hope for some crits here with Rock Blast. If he misses, the game just ends right here. If the Gastrum was cursed and it would war with the rest of the Clefable, who would win that 1v1? I think Clefable would win it because it's faster, but I'm not sure. But Gastrum is not cursed. Pretty obvious at this point. He did never went for it. He's gonna go for Rock Blast. ABR only, like, ABR only plays Moonblast here. He's obviously not gonna switch out. He already has two commons up. He got rid of the Celeste dealer successfully. And my man, Sorry, has the lobby open. He's like, I haven't lost yet. Like, nothing against my man, but like, I would concentrate on the battle and not have the lobby chat open. I feel like he was like really not like this is. I really don't want to criticize him because I also make mistakes in games, and like, he knows that. Like, he also criticizes me sometimes, but we troll each other for fun. Okay, I hate him for this nickname. He should. This is just some bad meme that we have going on in our chat. So he got one crit with the Rock Blast. This is still not an Earthquake range. So here we have two options here. Either he goes for Earthquake and ABR goes for Softball and Sorry is in a bad spot. Or he goes for Earthquake and ABR goes for Moonblast and Sorry is in a good spot, because then he can kill this with Psyshock. So ABR most likely might go for will go for Softboiled, knowing that Earthquake plus Psyshock would kill his Clefable. And Sorry predicts that immaculately goes for SD. So that was a fire play. So now he made that a bit for his shaky mid game. But yeah, I hate him so much for his nickname. You guys can probably imagine what this means. But yeah, this is just some bad meme. I definitely do not like. Yeah, I don't like feet. I don't know what the fuck. Why did he nickname this? So ABR sacks off the Midjourner. They are potentially scouted for a ground Z move, I think. So now he goes into the Heligo, and we don't know if this is HPIs. But HPIs is actually, if it's Scarf, it has to be Scarf HPIs, because the Ladi wasn't Scarf and he needs some speed control, or we talked about this. Scarf HPIs, I think it's a roll from here to kill the Garchomp, and I completely don't understand why he switched out there. Sorry should have just stayed and hoped that it got the roll. I think it was a roll in Sorry's favor. If it even kills. Sorry was fearing specs, but it was pretty obvious that it's not specs. And now this time the game is just over at this point, because like, he had to SD to do any damage if he just Earthquaked. Now I think at this point he shouldn't have switched out at all. But now that he stayed in with his Garchomp, SD wasn't the play, because ABR was gonna Moonblast there when he was at plus one. So if anything, at this point he should have gone for Earthquake crit into then Psyshock and hope that somehow kills. I don't think that would have I don't know if that even would have killed. But at this point he had to go for the crit. So ABR said it was HP 5 in the Heligo, and he bluffed the HPIs. So ABR played this pretty fire, I feel. But even if it was HPIs in the Heligo, like, you already had your plus 2 Garchomp, and you would have. Sorry had pretty much had the game at that point. I can pause real quick and show you guys the roll, but I'm pretty sure, like, I have run this card before, and the roll was in Sorry's favor. And like, you had your plus 2 Garchomp, like, there was no point in switching out. That's what you needed. You just had to stay in there. If you lift the HPIs that ABR didn't even have, he bluffed it. But ABR banked on that. Sorry was fearing the HPIs killing him. I don't want to say that he banked on the choke, but he kind of banked on the choke. So, And then, like, he basically had to hope that Sorry switches out there, because he only had HP fire, which is crazy. He bluffed the HPIs. But even if he had the HPIs, like I said, Sorry should have just stayed and hoped that he gets the roll at that point. Then he would have just won, because Earthquake does like 80 something to Clever plus 2. And then Psyshock would just pick up the game for Sorry at that point. But yeah, unfortunately, I feel like Sorry had this game, but. Yeah, so close to his first win in Snake, but yet he still didn't get it. Oh well. He will, this is a, like a learning experience for Sorry. I feel like this shows that like ABR has more experience in tournaments, but nothing against Sorry. The mid game he played like fire, and this was an interesting game to watch. Hope you guys all enjoyed. We have way more Snake Tour coming later. Searching for that, I'll cover some games. I'm a little bit sick, so I won't be able to cover that many, but yeah, some for sure. Yeah, Sorry should have won this game after he got the Toxic on the Zapdos, and then after then he misplayed a bit with his Celesteela, but he made up for it with that SD Garchomp play, but it sucks that he didn't just stay in with Garchomp. Oh well, I'll see you guys next time. Hope you all enjoyed, and congrats to ABR. I think he's 2-0 at the moment in Snake. He still has to play his third game. I don't know his opponent though, but yeah. Thank you guys for watching, and peace out.